you've been chosen. And because you have been chosen, there are many costs that are associated. One of those costs that are associated with being chosen is that to whom much is given, much is required. Being chosen means that you have gone through the darkest moments in order to come out shining like a star. People are drawn to your light. People that are hurting, people that are in cycles of self-sabotage, people who have been in deep waters, they are drawn to your light because you've already come out of it. What that means, friends, is that sometimes you will draw people to you that will, in essence, not be so kind. They haven't learned how to operate from the space of kindness and love. They haven't learned how to rise above their circumstances and let their light be seen. But that's why they were drawn to you. So don't fall into the trap of responding negatively to what they may say or what they may do. Just continue to let your light shine. Let your love shine through. Let the goodness inside of you continue to raise the standard in their life. I've learned a long time ago that where you respond is the level that you are on. So learn to let your goodness, to let your kindness, to let your love and forgiveness outshine all of the darkness that's around you. And God will continue to elevate you and to lift you high, but not only will he do that for you, but for those people that you have been kind to, that you have been good to, God will allow them to see your light and they'll come out on the other side because you had the courage to be good in the face of the darkness. You had the courage to let your light shine when the arrows of hurt and the arrows of pain, the arrows of accusations, the arrows of dismissal and rejection were spewed in your direction. You had the ability to let your light shine. And because of that, blessed are you that are persecuted. Blessed are you that let your light shine in the darkness. Remember who you are.